What's up guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix the problem when your Mac is not accepting your Apple ID login credentials. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. This problem is usually caused by user error, such as using the wrong keyboard layout when entering your password, because your Apple ID is not yet verified, or it's because of a network-related problem with the Apple servers. First of all, you should ensure that you're using the correct keyboard settings. Click on the language icon in your menu bar and select Open Keyboard Settings. This will allow you to make sure that the key mapping corresponds to the keyboard you are using. If it's not, then click on the plus icon and change the keyboard language. Next, while in your macOS settings, click on your Apple ID name and proceed to sign out of your Apple ID account if you're logged in. Otherwise, try logging in to see if the Apple ID servers are responding. Verify that you have a reliable network connection. Open up your browser of choice and load a page to see if your network connection is working fine. You can also make use of speedtest.net to see your average upload and download speed to the nearest server. While here, navigate to apple.com/support/system-status. All links to websites will be in my extensive guide linked in the description below. Here, ensure that the Apple ID servers are operational and not undergoing maintenance. When logging into your Apple ID account, some users who enabled two-factor authentication will have to allow the login through an email or by using another device. iPhone users might see a notification to allow access to your Apple ID when setting up your new Mac. Lastly, make sure that your Mac is running the latest macOS version. Back in your system settings, navigate to the General section. Click on Software Update and download the latest version before restarting your Mac. This will fix Apple ID login issues on your Mac. All of these steps and more information will be available in my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.